Worimi man Joe Perry has produced a history of the Karuah Aboriginal community in New South Wales as part of his Doctor of Philosophy at the University of Newcastle. His story tells of life growing up on the reserve and brings to light the challenges our people faced living in segregation. Karuah is the home of Queensland correspondent Jodan Perry's family, and he went back to have a talk to those closest to him.
This country is very dear to me. Just a stone's throw from the picturesque Karuah River, known for its abundance of oysters, sits a community of strong and proud Aboriginal people. Affectionately known as the MISH, the community at Karuah is lined with solid brick houses, a big improvement on what was offered to my mob in years gone past.
Well, we lived in our old shed first. It used to be the school's tool shed. We had a school on the mission because kids wasn't allowed to mix up with the white kids at school. Yeah, but drinking and drugs has hit the scene now, and it's not the same.
A history of the community is documented in my father's PhD, titled Mission Impossible, Aboriginal Survival Before, During and After the Aboriginal Protection Era. It chronicles life on the Karuah Mission, a story which will no doubt resonate with mob all over the country.
It was always going to be about Karuah. I wanted to tell the story about what it was like for Aboriginal people growing up and living on a mission. It was about telling stories about our ancestors, our family, our genealogy and our history. I think that's one of the most important things we need to do as Aboriginal people.
Passing on stories to our future generations is one of the central aspects of our culture, and Dad hopes that this story will give some insight into what life is like in our communities.
The wider society needs to understand what it was like for Aboriginal people living and growing up on missions and reserves under sometimes extreme pressure from government policies and practices that has destroyed not only Aboriginal families, their culture, but their very lives themselves.
The book is littered with recollections of the old days from my grandmother, who has recently been awarded an honorary doctorate of letters from the World Indigenous Nations University in Ontario, Canada, a big achievement considering the pressures she faced in the past.
I was born in a bark hut, no floor, no lights, no running water.
Mum was denied education under government policies and access to Western education. She's became self-educated just from reading in it, but she's always expressed to us the need for us to get ahead is to get an education. And I soon learnt that when you leave school and start labouring that you need to do more than just that in your life. There's much more that we can do as Aboriginal people. And education is not the answer, but it is a key to making those changes in our lives so that we can make those decisions about what's best for us.
Jodan Perry for NITV News.